Hi there, my name is Mordy Oberstein. I'm the head of SEO branding at Wix, and today I want to show you a great new tool that you can use to better optimize your pages for Google search, the SEO Assistant, which runs an on-page SEO audit on the page level and a little bit more. Let's dive into it. So to access the SEO Assistant, you have to go into the SEO panel. I'm working on a blog page right now. So the SEO panel is located in the left-hand navigation. I just click on SEO. And the first tab that is shown to me is for the SEO Assistant. Now you'll notice right off the bat, the SEO Assistant offers a series of, we'll call them SEO tasks. The first one, for example, is critical, and it's allow this post to get indexed, may appear in search results, meaning this task ensures that the page is ready to be crawled and indexed, is able to be crawled and indexed by search engines, that a no index tag has not been applied to this page. So far, so good. This critical SEO task has been done. That's the default. If I go down the list, for example, though, I might see items in red. For example, I have yet to write a meta description for this post. So that task is still in red. Now, let me show you how to get the most out of this tool. In order to get the most out of the SEO Assistant, we need to choose a focus keyword. I'm going to use Semrush in order to get some ideas. Now, my post here is all about SEO testing. So I'm going to go to my target market, which is the US, and I'm going to throw in SEO test. And let's see what Semrush returns to me. It'll give me a whole series of metrics to better determine what keyword I should focus or shouldn't focus on. So the first result here is SEO test. It has a monthly search volume of 1,300, meaning on average, about rough estimate, the term SEO test gets searched for on Google 1,300 times. However, if you'll notice, its difficulty to rank is hard. If I go down one, SEO testing, it doesn't have the same search volume as a search volume about roughly half of that, but it's a medium difficulty to rank and the trend is going upward, so it's getting more popular. If I go down, just look at one more, SEO tester has a search volume of even less at 480 and it's hard to rank for. Let's go for the medium one. And I'm going to apply this SEO testing. We'll click save. And now watch the SEO Assistant do its thing. You'll notice a slew of SEO tasks now show up. For example, add the focus keyword to the title tag. I already did this. Let's pretend that I did it. I can go here in the SEO Assistant and I can update my title tag on the spot. So I'll put in SEO testing. Oops. Get started. Or maybe how to get started would be more accurate for this post. Great. I'll click apply. And we're green. The title tag has been optimized for the focus keyword. If I go down to the next task, it's add the keyword, the focus keyword to the H1, meaning the main header on the page, which is here. I currently have SEO test. Let's update it to SEO testing. And we won't use the same one as a title tag because here, people already made the click from Google. What you need to know. Great. You'll see automatically the SEO Assistant realizes what I did on the page and it now puts that task in green. I also have H2 and H3 headings on the page. Actually, in this case, I only have an H2. It's right here. All about SEO tests, which is not even the best for the user's readability. And it doesn't target the focus keyword. So let's do a guide to SEO testing for beginners. Again, the SEO Assistant realizes what I've been doing on the page and it updates the task to be finished. Now you might have noticed that the top level summary here has changed. Before I completed my task, it was in red. Now you'll notice that it's in green. As you complete the task, the SEO Assistant will give you a visual signal of how well you're doing by changing the background color. You also see here that we have no critical tasks to be done. All of our high and medium priority tasks have been done. And there's just one remaining SEO task here, and it's for the meta description. In this case, I need to add one. Now, a meta description is not exactly part of the ranking equation. It's not one of the official ranking factors that Google has. However, it is really important for getting clicks from the Google results page. Google may show the meta description that you wrote on the actual results page, and it may influence whether or not somebody searching on Google for the focus keyword clicks on your site or on a different site. So I'm going to put get started running tests for SEO. SEO testing is hard, but maybe it doesn't have to be. Learn what you need to know. It has the focus keyword and it's conversational. I think it might induce a click. Let's see. We'll test it out, see what happens, but we'll click apply. And now all of my SEO tasks are completed here. We're green across the board. Every SEO task has been finished. And what's amazing about the tool is I also understand if the page has been indexed or not by Google. Now, at this point, it's not indexed by Google because I haven't actually published it yet. And the SEO assistant tells me as much. Get the index status for this post after you publish the post, meaning first publish the post, and then we'll let you know if Google has indexed it or not. Now, indexing can take time. It's not immediate after you publish. It may take any given amount of time. However, you will be able to see it right here in the SEO assistant, which is absolutely amazing information for you. Now, let's jump to a different post, one that I already published so we can see the indexation status, and one where I want to show you where perhaps maybe we shouldn't complete all the SEO tasks, as funny as that sounds. So here's a post that I already optimized, I already released, but I didn't use the SEO assistant for until after I already published it, which may actually be the workflow that you find yourself in. In such a case, there's an issue I want to bring up to your attention. If you'll notice here, I bring up the SEO assistant, I have everything finished except for one, and that's to add the focus keyword to the URL. In this case, my keyword, by the way, was content creator tips. My URL was memorable SEO content. I could change it, and I could update the URL in order to satisfy the task listed by the SEO assistant so that we're green across the board. But the problem is this URL, this post has already been published, which means if an external site is linking to this page, if it's using this URL as a link on that page, that link will be broken because I've changed the URL. If I'm linking from one of my other pages on my own website via an internal link to this page, well, those links will also be broken unless I do a redirect, which I really don't want to do. And in general, URLs per Google, the keyword in URLs rather, is a very, very lightweight ranking factor, which is why, by the way, we prioritize it as low within the SEO assistant. My personal philosophy is unless you really have to change a URL, don't. Leave it alone. It's a very low priority task. In this case, I did not change the URL. Again, unless you really have to change a URL, then leave it alone. And if you do change the URL, please make sure you do a redirect. Now, the last thing I want to show you is down here, you can see the indexation status, which is it's valid. Again, this is a post I already published. Google had the time to crawl in and index it. And I know that it's indexed because I've connected my site to Search Console. And because I've connected my site to Search Console, I can now see the indexation status automatically right here in the SEO panel. And that's how you conduct an on-page SEO audit using the SEO assistant. Happy optimizing and future success to you with all of your SEO efforts and beyond.